Hi, this is Mark Frechette from Georgetown County School District, and this is video two in a series of our e-learning videos for Georgetown County School District. This video is actually made for students so that they can understand how to go online, go to their assignments in Google Classroom, and either download or move their files, and then make sure that they've checked their drive to be sure that they're downloaded, and also check the settings of the drive to make sure that they can access those materials offline if they're borrowing a district device. So in order to do that, I'm going to walk you through these steps as a student. What I'm going to do is I'm going to come up here to classwork, and as a student, I have an assignment called one-word e-learning activity. I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to choose view assignment. When I choose view assignment, what it does is it kind of shows me the different types of files that I have in here. So for this assignment, there's a video that my teacher shared with me that I have viewing rights to. There's also an article that my teacher shared with me that is a PDF version that, again, they shared with me. I have viewing rights only. I do not own the file. And then I have a file up here, which is a template of a Google slide that they created for me. And again, I own that file. So these two I don't own. This one I do own. So for these two, I'm going to have to download these and make sure that they're downloaded to the district device. So that way, if I do go home and I don't have Wi-Fi, I can still access those and watch those. And I'm going to have to move this file right here that I do own. It's got my name on it. I'm going to move this so that way I can have access to it offline. So it's real simple to do that. What I'm going to do is I'm going to click on each of these files. So first, I'm going to start with the ones that have view rights only. And you can tell that because they did not have my name at the top. The video is easy because right here, as I open it, you'll see where it says download. I'm going to choose the download option. It will then go ahead and it will tell me in my download manager that it is downloading this video. It's in progress, and it'll also notify me when it's done. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and close this window because that'll continue to download. I'm going to close that tab. And now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go to the other file that my teacher shared with me that's called, oh, and you can see my download for the video is complete. I can just close this by hitting that X. And then I'm going to go to the article. I'm going to click on that. And this time, when I click on the article, I actually have to take one more step. So I'm going to click on these three little dots and hit open in a new tab in order to get the download option. So once I've done that, I'm going to come right here to this download, and I'm going to click download. And again, you'll notice in my download manager, it'll tell me when the article is complete, and this article is complete. So I can just close that by hitting the X. I can come up here and I can close this, and it'll take me back to right where I was at the article before I hit the three dots. So I'm going to choose back. And now I've downloaded both of these that I had view rights for. Now I need to go ahead and I need to move the file with my name on it. So I'm going to click on this. It'll open it up in slides. And then what I'm going to do is you'll see that there'll be a little folder that appears right up here. Once that folder appears, what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually click on this. By the way, if it takes a couple seconds for your folder to appear, just wait a couple seconds and it will show up eventually. So I'm going to click on this, and now I've got to move this. So I'm actually going to click the back arrow, and I want to move this right out to the beginning part of my drive, so that way I'll know where to access it. So now it says my drive up at the top, and all I did was choose that back arrow. If you go too far, it's okay. You can just click on my drive and you can hit move. And it's going to say organizing, and then it's going to tell me that it's been moved into my drive, which is perfect because that's exactly where I need it. So again, what I had to do was in this assignment, I clicked on view assignment. The two assignments that were files that my teacher shared, I had to go ahead and download. The one assignment that my teacher gave me that has my name on it that I own, I just had to move. So that's the difference of the two. there's one more step we need to take. So now what we need to do is we need to go to our Google Drive to make sure that we can access this offline, just in case we don't have Wi-Fi connectivity. So I'm going to click on these and click on Drive. And you'll see, the first thing I'm going to do is check my Drive to see that I have the video, the article, and then the Google slide. So you can see I have the Google slide with my name on it. I have the video, and then I have the article right here. So all of them are right in the beginning of my Drive. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to come up to my Drive, and I want to make sure that I have access to these if I'm offline. So I'm going to come here. I'm going to click on this, and I'm going to go to Settings. The key thing is right down here, I want to check to see where it says offline and make sure that this has been selected, where it says create, open, and edit your recent Google Docs, Sheets, and Slides files on this device while offline. This needs to be checked. If it is not, go ahead and check it. If you have any issues with this, notify your teacher and they'll contact IT. Once I've done that, I'm going to go ahead and click Done. And now I can access these offline. So that's the first step in this video series, is how to go ahead and download these. The next video I'm going to show you is how to access these when you're at home or you're offline on the GCSD device. So good luck downloading or moving your files.